Scott Hamilton. Scott, I know you've had a little bit of a chance to get your breath after the men's last night. And, of course, the women's competition coming up next week.
Well, the women's competition is going to be great. I still haven't gotten over what Paul Wiley accomplished last night. What an exciting men's competition. If you think back 4 years to the Calgary Olympic Games, the battle for the gold medal with the ladies came down to two women, Debbie Thomas and Katarina Witt. If you think back over the last 2 years of world championships, of the six medals awarded to the ladies, five have been won by Americans by five different women. Well, three of them have been appointed to the Olympic team. They're all here, and Midori Ito of Japan is definitely going to be a factor. They're here, and they're gearing up for battle. The ladies took the ice in the training rink this afternoon for a little original program practice. Nancy Kerrigan looking very confident and relaxed. Kristi Yamaguchi returned from Megev, a city a few miles away. She's been training there. She's back in Albertville, and her attitude looks as easygoing as this double axel. Her chief rival, Midori Ito of Japan, looked on, checking out the competition. When they return to the main rink, this triple-triple combination shows that Midori Ito is probably the finest jumper in the women's event. Meanwhile, in an empty accreditation center, Tanya Harding, the last member of the U.S. skating team to arrive, got her credentials, seeming to look forward to her first Olympic experience.
There's no pressure on me. I feel just like I did going into the 1991 Nationals. I feel good.
And back in the main rink, Kristi Yamaguchi for her free program shows that she's got a triple-triple combination of her own. But for Kristi Yamaguchi, it's not just jumps. It's artistry, choreography. Kristi Yamaguchi is a complete skater.
At its best, figure skating is a marriage of grace and beauty. At her best, Kristi Yamaguchi is what figure skating is all about. Clean, elegant performances have made her both world and national champion. But the 20-year-old from Fremont, California says she'd skate even if they didn't give out medals.
I'm skating because I love skating and I enjoy performing and, just giving the crowd something to enjoy. So sometimes I also ask myself, why do I compete? But, I've never said, why do I skate? Because I've always loved it.
She began skating at the age of six when her mother signed her up for lessons. And despite being born with club feet, Kristi showed natural ability right from the start. Her parents didn't want their daughter to get too carried away with the life of a figure skater, so no tutors or special schools or special treatment.
I was lucky in that I was able to attend normal high school for 2 years and be around kids my own age. Of course, I didn't take part in much extracurricular activities because I didn't have time for it. But, I didn't mind because skating was more important to me and I was willing to put more into that than school.
For 7 years, Kristi skated pairs with Rudy Galindo. And in 1989, she became the first American woman since 1954 to qualify for the World Championships in both singles and pairs. But the strain of trying to skate in both disciplines made Kristi decide to go solo.
Once she'd made up her mind a year ago to just concentrate on the singles, I think everything came into focus. Everything came in and became clearer.
In order to continue her solo career, Kristi had to make a move, and that move was to Edmonton, Canada, where her singles coach, Kristi Kasgard-Ness, lives. Together, they share a very special relationship.
It just kind of perhaps changed me in a little way just by showing me the importance of how important it is that you skate for yourself and that it has to be the skater that really wants it. As a coach, you can't put it into a person. But when a skater really feels like that and says, this is what I want to do, I love what I'm doing, and I'm going to try the very best I can, and then let the chips fall where they may.
The chips fell perfectly into place last month in Orlando when Kristi skated a flawless free program and came away with her first national singles title.
Well, I think this past year, that's when I finally realized that all the years and the early mornings and many hours of hard work do start to pay off. You stay in it and you stay focused, and in the end, things start to work out.
Kristi Yamaguchi.